Well, for Aussies living with type 1 diabetes, the financial burden can be overwhelming, with many forking out thousands for life-saving devices. Thankfully, financial aid is on the way. The Health Minister will announce today that wearable insulin pump technology will be available through public subsidy. For more on this, we are joined by endocrinologist Dr. Kin and Hughes. Kin, and great to see you this morning. This will no doubt change the lives of people who are living with this condition.
Yeah, well, that's right. Type 1 diabetes is a immune condition where the immune system attacks the pancreas and it can't make insulin. And insulin's essential for using glucose in the body. So most people with type 1 need to inject insulin multiple times a day with a needle and syringe, or with insulin pens more commonly. But these new insulin pump technologies that have become available are really revolutionising the care of our people with type 1 in lots of ways. The subsidy that's been announced today relates to the Omnipod device, mm-hmm. Which is a pump that's attached to the body, and it continuously infuses insulin. To more tightly manage your glucose levels.
Yeah, right. With the good news comes some bad news. Recently we saw that there was a recall issued for this particular device with the battery pack. What more do we know about that?
Yeah, so just recently, just last week in fact, Insulet let us know that there was an issue with the battery pack overheating potentially, and that that may carry a risk of fire. Just for clarity, you can think of the device as being two things. One is the pump with the insulin that's attached to you, and the other is a bit like a smartphone that controls that pump. And so it's the battery within that smart device that can overheat. It seems that the current guidance is not for a recall, it's just to inspect the pack, make sure it's not overheating or warped, sure, and also to not overcharge it, so don't leave it plugged in charging overnight. And it seems the solution is going to be a software upgrade that will limit overcharging of that battery.
For type 1 diabetics, I was reading a lovely story in the paper this morning, the headline, "I'm now free thanks to this subsidy." This will have huge, not only physical, but mental impact as well for type 1 diabetics.
Yeah, well, I think type 1 diabetes is a really difficult condition to live with. You never get to have a break. You've got to focus on it. Every meal, you've got to think about it. And these technologies are really revolutionising the way we care for people, because we're getting continuous glucose monitoring data and we're getting insulin that can be delivered to control sugars to the optimal level. And with that, you get peace of mind, you get avoidance of complications, not just for the person living with it, but also for their loved ones.
Making clear this subsidy as well, just the impact that it will have, we are talking $400 a month for some patients, now being brought right down to about $29 a month. That is a huge burden that these people have been bearing in this time. This will make a huge difference for them.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, a lot of these insulin pumps are costing sort of, $3,000 to $4,000 a year. The subsidy that's been announced for Omnipod will roughly halve that, because there is still a separate copay required to the company. Mm-hmm. But nonetheless, it's a couple thousand dollars a year of savings for these people.
So can more be done in that regard?
Of course, we'd always want more. So I'd like to see a situation where there is public subsidy of insulin pumps and CGM for all people living with type 1 diabetes in Australia. Mm. Because right now, most of these technologies are still limited to those that have private health insurance or that can afford that $2,000 or $3,000 a year.
And is it one size fits all? I mean, how do people access this sort of technology if they are type 1 diabetic? Is this system going to work for them?
Sure. So the current subsidies are accessed through the NDSS, and at a realistic level that means seeing either an endocrinologist like me or a diabetes educator. For many type 1s, they're not already engaged with one of those professionals, and so certainly their primary care physician, their GP, should be their first point of call.
Yeah.